So, just now we heard Mr. Satyakumar, very nice ideas he has given convincingly, that how the Indian ethos, as explained and propagated by Swami Vivekananda, can be very beneficial to the modern management. These are all the ideas based on Indian ethos. He gave two examples. When Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam came to Porbandar on 12 January 2006, as you know, 12 January is celebrated as National Youth Day because it is Swami Vivekananda's birthday. Are you listening?
Yes.
Most of the people are talking within themselves. I think there is some problem there. Thodo kai problem thiyo che? Question pachi lagjo, tea break man lagjo, kai vando nahi, don't worry. You can write the questions during the tea break and give to us, write down the name of the person from whom you want the answer. Of course, Vijay Menon will have to leave immediately after his lecture because he has to take a flight, another flight from Ahmedabad. He has to go all the way to Ahmedabad by car, take another flight and go to, from Ahmedabad, go to Chennai at night, again take another flight from Chennai to Kerala. So he will be traveling whole night. He has been traveling whole night. Still he has come only for 1 hour, half an hour. So because he is also a disciple, Satyakumar is a disciple of Ramakrishna Mission, official disciple, initiated disciple. Vijay Menon, official disciple. Dr. Radhakrishnan, not yet. Not yet. Suresh Pandit, yes, official disciple. Sarat Sagar, gone last year, disciple of our order. So, they are all coming here and getting strength and spiritualized and now spiritualizing the world with their power. So, I was telling you about Dr. Kalam's speech at Porbandar. During that, because that was Swami Vivekananda's birthday, so Dr. Kalam said that today is the day, birthday of a great person, not only of India, but of the whole globe. Then he narrated this incident, what Mr. Satyakumar said. He said, Swami Vivekananda was traveling from Japan to Chicago. Swami Vivekananda was going for participating in the World's Parliament of Religions. As you know, he delivered his historic speech at the World Parliament of Religion in Chicago on 11 September 1893. So 31st May 1893, he started from Bombay. From Bombay, he went to Japan. From Japan, he took the steamer to Chicago. In Japan, he met Jamsetji Tata. And Jamsetji Tata was going from Japan to Chicago for some other purpose. He was going because there was an industrial fair there. And during the talks, there were a lot of talks in the ship, in the steamer, traveling from Japan to Chicago. At that time, Swami Vivekananda asked Jamsetji Tata why he was going. Then he said, I am going to find out the technology. Then Dr. Kalam said, it is Swami Vivekananda who said, technology is very good. You must have industry here that will give employment to the people and the wealth will be here only. And you must also have research institute. So these ideas were planted in the minds of Jamsetji Tata by Swami Vivekananda, because Swami Vivekananda told many times, what we want in our country now is Western science coupled with Vedanta. Vedanta is Indian ethos. We want Western science coupled with Vedanta. That is why Swami Vivekananda told Jamsetji Tata. And Jamsetji Tata, when he started this project of Indian Institute of Science, he wrote a letter to Swami Vivekananda from Bombay, 23 November 1898. He is writing from Esplanade, Bombay, from Tata House. He writes to Swami Vivekananda that you may remember me as a co-traveler from Japan to Chicago, at which time you told me about the need of keeping a few men who are devoted to spirituality as well as science. You might have doubtless heard about the scheme of Indian Institute of Science that I am having, I am going to start. And Jamsetji Tata writes, and I know not of a person who can be the general of this campaign than Swami Vivekananda. I know not of a general who can be the, I know not of a person who can be the general of this great campaign than Swami Vivekananda. So you have to be the general, and you be the general of this campaign, and I want your help. And I will not mind defraying expenses for the imprinting the brochures that you will be releasing. And then Swami Vivekananda, he related it later to Prabuddha Bharata, and editor Prabuddha Bharata wrote a beautiful article inviting all the Indians to join in this campaign. And Swami Vivekananda put Sister Nivedita on the job, and Sister Nivedita then later on carried this forward, and that is how Indian Institute of Science was started. I had the great fortune of visiting Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore for the first time this month. On 4th of December, I had gone there for a lecture. While going to airport on the way, I stopped for 2 hours at Indian Institute of Science. And there I met a great scientist called Dr. Jagdish. He told, previously, when he is also a disciple of Ramakrishna Mission, previously when we used to say that Jamsetji Tata was inspired by Swami Vivekananda for starting Indian Institute of Science, nobody was taking any care. But after when Dr. Kalam, he saw with his own eyes the letter, he said, we were the persons who got this original letter written by Jamsetji Tata in his own handwriting. When he saw that letter, then he became convinced, and when Dr. Kalam started telling, now everybody says, yes, 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 Swami Vivekananda was instrumental in starting of the Indian Institute of Science. Whatever it is, Swami Vivekananda wanted the combination of Western science coupled with Vedanta philosophy. Indian ethos is nothing but Vedanta philosophy. Indian ethos is based on Indian ethos, Indian philosophy, Vedanta philosophy. So we have to take care of both. We do not want only to sit down in our own small well, like a frog in the well. No. Swami Vivekananda said, we will have to have combination of both East and West. But we have enough of material in Indian culture, Indian ethos, that we should not forget. We have a great wealth of wisdom is there in our scriptures. We should not forget that. We should not wait for the Westerners to find out that wealth and import that wealth then later on. We have ourselves. This is what he pointed out. Even Gandhiji said, I keep my doors and windows open, but I refuse to be blown off. I refuse to be blown off. I will accept all the Indian culture, all the Western culture, philosophy, whatever are good things in the Western philosophy, in the Western science, but I refuse to be blown off. Why? Because I know I have grounded on the solid land, a solid state of this Indian philosophy, which is no way inferior. In fact, that is the mother of all the other philosophies in the world. So this great pride we must have, that we have a very great cultural heritage, and all our management wisdom all derived from that. In fact, we had thousands of years back, they were Rajarshis. Sri Krishna was a great management guru, and he practiced servant leadership 3,000 years back. And we had all those things. But in between, we became slave, and our mind also became slave. And we became slavish tendency, and so we find that we have nothing to give to the world. We have only to take from the Western world, take from the management wisdom also, we have to take from outside. This slavish tendency has to be given up. Why we have this seminar? We must know what a rich culture heritage we have, what a rich wisdom, management wisdom we have. We have enough to not only for ourselves, but we have enough to give to others. That does not mean we close the doors and windows. Yes, we will take whatever is good in Japanese style of management, in American style of management, but Indian management should be run in the Indian style and not the Western style. That is what we want to say. He was telling about that incident of Rockefeller. Now, you know, there's a big problem. 1% of the people in the world are having 99% of the wealth. 1% of the people of the world are having 99% of the wealth. There are so many billionaires are increasing. On the other hand, poor people are also increasing. In our country also, 10% are suffering from affluenza, 40% suffering from malnutrition below poverty line. There is a big gap between have and have nots. How to bridge the gap? Swami Vivekananda found out the solution. He found out a solution 100 years back, more than 100 years back, when he had gone to Chicago for participating in the World Parliament Regions. Then he was so popular and he was so much in demand that to remain there for 3.5 years more in America preaching Vedanta. So when Swamiji was in Chicago in 1894, at that time, just now as you heard, the richest person of the world was John D. Rockefeller. At that time, he was the emperor of petroleum industry. At that time, he was passing through a very bad phase. He was undergoing tremendous tension. He was very nervous. And in fact, he had become prey of depression, terribly depressed. All his hair had gone. He had become emaciated. And he was on the verge of dying. At that time, his friend suggested, why don't you come to my friend's house? An Indian yogi has come, Swami Vivekananda, and by getting his advice, perhaps you may get peace of mind. Rockefeller said, what? I to go to a beggar for getting advice? No, I will not go. You know, we are all beggars. We live on charity. We live on donation. So Rockefeller said, what? I to go to a beggar for getting advice? No, I will not go. And he did not go. One fine morning, suddenly he came to the place where Swamiji was staying. He called the bell. The butler opened the door. He went inside. Swamiji was not in his drawing room. So he went to his study room without being announced. And you know, Swamiji had tremendous power of concentration. He will do one thing at a time. So he was so much absorbed, he did not notice Rockefeller coming to his room. Rockefeller stood for some time. Then he knocked at the table. Swamiji looked up. Rockefeller said, I'm Rockefeller. Swamiji said, what do you want? Now he was not prepared for this type of treatment. Rockefeller means the president of America would get up from his seat and here's the beggar sitting and asking me, what do you want? And he became very much annoyed. I don't want anything. Then why have you come? Now he had no answer because he had come without invitation. Then Swami Vivekananda said, Rockefeller, I know why you have come. You come here because you do not have peace of mind. And then he narrated many incidents from the life of Rockefeller which no one else knew except Rockefeller. Then Rockefeller became very much excited. Who has told all this to you? How do you come to know? Swamiji said, do you think it is necessary? I can see through your mind as I can see through a glass self. Then Rockefeller was very much nonplussed. My God, he has come to know all my secrets. Then Swamiji said, my dear Rockefeller, I would like to give you a piece of advice. Remember, you are not the owner of your wealth. You are a custodian of your wealth, only a trustee of your wealth. Utilize this money for removing the sufferings of millions of people. That is the only way you can get peace of mind. There is no other way by which you can get peace of mind. Rockefeller was not prepared to listen to anybody's advice, least of all from a beggar, from a saint. What? How dare you say like this to me? How dare you advise? And he left the place abruptly, as abruptly he had come, in annoyance. But after a few days, again he came. Similar fashion, called the bell. The butler opened the door. Swamiji was not in his drawing room, so he went to study room. Swamiji was fully absorbed. Again, he knocked at the table. Swamiji looked up. Then Rockefeller put a piece of paper in which he had made an announcement of a very huge donation for a public cause. When Swami Vivekananda read it, Rockefeller said, "Now, you must thank me. I have followed your advice." Swamiji said, "Well, it is for you to thank me." Because by following my advice, you will get peace of mind which cannot be purchased by millions of dollars in the market. That was a very huge donation for a public cause. I do not know what it is. Most probably it was for Chicago, University of Chicago, whatever it is. But Swami Vivekananda gave the lesson of trusteeship management. And this is not his original. These ideas are given in Ishavashyapanishad. Mahatma Gandhi also popularized this theme of trusteeship management, but it is given in our scriptures, in Indian ethos. What is Indian ethos? Upanishads, Mahabharata, Ramayana, Gita, scriptures, this is all Indian ethos. So in Ishavashyapanishad, there is a shloka, Ishavashyamidam sarvam, yatkincha jagatyam jagat, tena taktena bhunditha, ma gridakasya siddhanam. Ishavasamidam saram. The whole world is permeated by one universal consciousness. Now the modern world, modern quantum mechanics has proved it beyond doubt. What is written in Ishavasamidam? The whole world is permeated by one universal consciousness. And this is what modern quantum mechanics says. It is a holistic universe. Bell's theorem states all the particles of the whole universe are interconnected at a deeper level. And David Bohm, another Nobel Prize winner, has experimentally proved that this is a holistic universe. And that is why Schrodinger says, consciousness is a singular of which the plural is unknown. Consciousness is a singular of which the plural is unknown. It is one universal consciousness in the whole world. So Ishavashyapanishad says, Ishavasyamidam sarvam. Yatkincha jagatyam jagat. There is one universal consciousness permeating the whole world. God is permeating the whole world. So, Ishavasyamidam sarvam yatkincha jagatyam jagat. Tena tyaktena bhunjitha. Enjoy the world by renunciation. Huh? How can you enjoy the world by renunciation? How can you enjoy the world by renunciation? Enjoy the world by renunciation, by giving up. You don't have to give up your latest model mobile, latest model car, latest model house. What you have to renounce? You have to renounce your ego. You have to renounce your selfishness. You have to renounce your attachment. So, Ishavasyamidam sarvam yatkincha jagatyam jagat tena taktena bhunjitha ma gridakasya siddhanam. Do not covet anybody's health, anybody's wealth. There is no harm in becoming rich, but don't become rich at the cost of others. Ethical power, power of ethical management. Now books are coming out on the power of ethical management, but this principle ethics was told in Ishavashyapanishad. There is a book by Norman Vincent Peale. You must have heard his name, the famous writer of The Power of Positive Thinking, Norman Vincent Peale. Kenneth Blanchard, another management expert, his many books are very, very popular, 1 Minute Manager and all that. So Kenneth Blanchard and Norman Vincent Peale, they have written a book. The name of the book is The Power of Ethical Management, where they say to work only for profit is like playing the tennis ball with your eyes on the scoreboard rather than on the ball. To work only for profit is like playing tennis with your eyes on the scoreboard rather than on the ball. What is going to happen if your eyes are not on the scoreboard, not on the ball? Zero. So, to work only for profit, and they say that you need not cheat in order to win. And they have given many case stories that when there was a slowdown, economic slowdown in America, what were the companies which survived? Only the companies which had adhered to values, to ethics, these companies survived, lest wiped out. And that is why, in the long run, satyameva jayate. In the long run, satyameva jayate. And Swami Vivekananda says, at long last you will understand, not now, at long last you will understand that the best way to become happy is to see that others are happy, and the best way to get peace of mind is to pray for others' peace of mind. And then he also says, unselfishness is more paying in the long run. Unfortunately, people do not have the patience to practice it. Unselfishness is more paying in the long run. Unfortunately, people do not have the patience to practice it. So, this principle was given in the Isha Vashtupanishad. Do not covet others' wealth. Earn the wealth by ethical means. But enjoy the world how? By renouncing your ego, by renouncing your attachment, renouncing your selfishness. Isha vastamidam sarvam yatkincha jagatyam jagat tena taktena bhunjitha ma grita kasya siddhanam. This was the message of trusteeship management. For the first time in the corporate sector, it was given by Swami Vivekananda to John D. Rockefeller, the emperor of petroleum industry. And now, Bill Gates, the richest person of the world today, at present, is also making a lot of charity. When first time then Bill Gates came to India, there was a newspaper report that some reporter asked him, why you have come to India? He said, because I love Indian culture. Why do you love? Because I am influenced by the books of Swami Vivekananda. Have you read any book of Swami Vivekananda? He said, yes, I have read many books of Swami Vivekananda. I don't go to bed without reading a few pages from the books of Swami Vivekananda. And Karma Yoga is my favorite book. This is what came in the newspaper. When I was told about it, I did not believe it. Because my idea of Bill Gates at that time, I'm talking about 20 years back, that he believes in cutthroat policy. How a person who believes in cutthroat policy can be a follower of Swami Vivekananda. But after 1 year, when I read that Bill Gates has announced that he keeping a few thousands of dollars, $10 million for his two children, he will donate all his property for the charity. Not only that, he created Melinda Bill Gates Foundation, and $30 billion he put into that trust. And every year from that time onward, the greatest charity, maximum charity, maximum philanthropy is Bill Gates from that time. Every year, he is making the biggest gain. So I wanted to confirm whether what is I have written there in newspaper, whether it's true or not. So I went to the website of Bill Gates. There, I asked this question, have you read any book of Swami Vivekananda? The answer was, we do not give replies to such question. If you want donation, go to this site. If you want to get this one, but you go to that site, you know, they are standard replies. There is no this one. Anyway, but there in his biography, it is written that Bill Gates says, I got my inspiration of doing charity from David Rockefeller. And David Rockefeller is the youngest son of John D. Rockefeller. And John D. Rockefeller got his inspiration from Swami Vivekananda. The circuit is complete. At least indirectly we can say that Bill Gates got his inspiration. So whatever things are coming up, gradually we will find out the genesis there on Indian ethos. This idea of trusteeship management. Now, in the government of India, I started CSR, Corporate Social Responsibility. When you do not practice trusteeship management, then government of India says, okay, we will compel you to practice by CSR. At least 2% of your profit you must give for CSR project, for helping projects. Very good. Anyway, this Swami Vivekananda's message has got a very, very important thing. In Indian Ethos, talks about trust system management. This only can solve the problems of the world. What is the solve problem? There are two problems. The people who are rich are suffering from affluenza, and the children of these affluent people, they are committing suicide, they are becoming schizophrenic, they are becoming drug addict, they are getting drug addict, they are becoming schizophrenic. Why? Because they have too much wealth. On the other hand, so many people are suffering. Why? Because they did not have to eat. They do not have wealth. Here are the people who do not have the wealth, who do not have the wealth, are suffering because of lack of money, lack of food, lack of items. Here, the other people, they are suffering too much of mobile, too much of car, too much of wealth, and too much of spoiling because of excessive wealth. So that is why Swami Vivekananda said, take the wealth from these people who are suffering from wealth, give to the poor people. So problem of poor people solved. And when they give the, when they give this wealth out of their compassion and out of their desire for doing charity, what happens? They will get peace of mind. Wealthy people do not have peace of mind. Poor people do not have wealth. Give the wealth from wealthy people to poor people. Poor people gets problems. Problem of poor people solved. Problem of wealthy people all solved. Killing two birds at a time. That is trusteeship management given by Swami Vivekananda 100 years back. Now, we are talking about stress management. Why Indian Ethos is becoming very popular? Because the Western models of stress management are not working. You know what is Western models of stress management? Because the Western psychologists say, you know, when you do not express your feelings, then those feelings go inside your brain, inside your subconscious mind, and then they try to create problem. So what you should do? You should express your feelings. My God, if I express my feelings, I'll lose my job. I am coming out, my boss is coming out from his house, and his wife gives a very good heavy dose. So my boss cannot tell anything to his wife, because otherwise she will go back to her house, who will cook the food. So the boss pockets the insult, he comes to the office, and right and left, he goes on scolding me without any reason. And I also know how to pay back at the same coin, but I cannot, because I will lose my job. So I pocket that insult. That insult goes inside the subconscious mind, and that creates stress, and later on that creates strain. So what we should do? The modern psychologists say, no. You must express your feelings. My God, if I express my feelings, I will lose my job. Then the psychologists say, don't worry. We have a solution. Go to the market and purchase voodoo dolls, head diaries, punching bags. These voodoo dolls, bring the voodoo dolls along with that pins also will come. Come back to your house. Close the doors and windows of your room. Put the voodoo doll on your table. Then write down the name of your boss or your mother-in-law or your wife or your husband, whomsoever you want to. Your stress, put out your stress. Write down the name and then go on punching. The pins are, blue pins are available for injury. Black pins are available if you want to seriously injure. And red pins are also available for killing. Just take the right pin and just kill your boss. And you will have a nice sleep without any tranquilizer whole night. But unfortunately, these are temporary solutions, because second day again the boss sitting on the chair, what to do? You killed him in your room last night. Again the fellow is on the chair. Again he is scolding. So these temporary methods of stress management, voodoo dolls, punching bags, you know, go on punching. Write down the name of the boss and the punching bag and go on give punching. Or head diaries, what you cannot say, go on writing the diary. Don't show the diary to the boss, huh? Or to your mother-in-law or your husband. Just go on writing, whatever you feel like. So these are all Western models of stress management that are not working. That is why The fourth wave of management is coming, Indian style of management, because yoga and meditation gives permanent solutions to this stress management. That is why they are coming. And then we have formulas in our scriptures to put out the stress. You know, in the month of March, now again it is coming, again we will have a program. You know, special type of program. How to overcome tension of board examination. Students are so much under tension. So we had a special program, how to overcome tension of board examination. Because the education minister said, you do something, Swamiji, these children are committing suicide, something has to be done. So he took me to the studio. We have Vizag studio. Through Vizag studio also I told them. Then at Rajkot also we organized a seminar, how to overcome tension of board examination. Then I called all the students, okay, how many of you are having tension? Please raise your hand. All of them raised their hand. How much tension? More or less? Jyada tension and kam hai. Vadhare tension che ke uchhu che? Bohu vadhare che. Okay. Afterwards, I said, okay, all of you have got good high tension. Okay, very nice. Now, I said, you tell me one thing. Tension sa mate aave che. હું કહી દઉં, જ્યારે તમે વિચાર કરો છો હાય હાય મને ફિઝિક્સમાં 90% મળશે કે નહીં, હાય હાય કેમિસ્ટ્રીમાં 98% મળશે કે નહીં, હાય હાય પરીક્ષામાં સારા નંબર મળશે કે નહીં, હાય હાય શું થશે, હાય હાય હાય, ઓનલી પ્રોબ્લેમ કમ્સ. ટેન્શન ક્યારે આવે છે? જ્યારે તમે પરીક્ષાના રિઝલ્ટની ચિંતા કરો છો ત્યારે. તો પરીક્ષાના રિઝલ્ટની ચિંતા કરવાથી પરીક્ષામાં સારા નંબર મળશે કે ઓછા નંબર મળશે? બસ જો પરીક્ષામાં ચિંતા કરવાથી નંબર વધવાનો હોય તો ખૂબ ટેન્શન લ્યો, પણ પરીક્ષામાં ટેન્શન લેવાથી તમારો નંબર ન વધવાનો હોય તો શા માટે ચિંતા કરો છો? ચિંતા કરવાથી નંબર ઓછા થશે, વધશે નહીં. એક્ઝામ્પલ, એક છોકરો હતો, એને એના પપ્પાએ કીધું 12th સાયન્સમાં છો, જને સારા નંબર મળશે. ઓ આઈ થિંક આઈ સ્ટાર્ટેડ ઇન ગુજરાતી, અચ્છા આઈ વિલ ટોક ઇન ઇંગ્લિશ. ગુજરાતી, અચ્છા ઠીક છે, થોડુંક ગુજરાતી 5-10 મિનિટ. આપણ ઓનલાઈન થાય છે, બિચારા લોકો અમેરિકામાં જીવે છે, એ લોકોને શું થશે? એમાં એક ગુજરાતી છે થોડાક. તો પેલા 12th સાયન્સમાં છોકરો હતો, એના પિતાજી, જો તું પરીક્ષામાં સારા નંબર લાવીશ ને હું તને અમેરિકા મોકલી દઈશ. બસ હવે આ છોકરો ભણવા બેઠો, ભણતા ભણતા શું વિચાર કરે છે, અરે પરીક્ષામાં કેવું રિઝલ્ટ આવશે, સારું આવશે કે ખરાબ. વળી થોડાક પાના ગયા, સારું રિઝલ્ટ આવશે ને તો બહુ મજા આવી જશે. વળી સારા થોડાક પાના ગયા, અરે વાહ રે વાહ, સારું રિઝલ્ટ આવશે ને તો પપ્પા મને અમેરિકા મોકલશે, અરે બહુ મજા આવી જશે. હું વળી થોડાક પણ ગયા, અચ્છા અમેરિકામાં જઈશ તો ક્યાં રહીશ, કાકા સાથે રહીશ કે હોસ્ટેલમાં? ના ના ના, કાકા સાથે રહીશ તો વળી ફ્રીડમ નહીં મળે યાર, ચાલો આપણે પછી એકલા રહેશું. અચ્છા અચ્છા ઠીક છે, પછી કઈ જગ્યાએ રહું, આ જગ્યાએ રહું કે ત્યાં જગ્યાએ? ના ના ના, ત્યાં જ રહીશ. અમર કે આ બધું ક્યારે વિચારે છે? ભણતી વખતે. સારા નંબર મળશે કે ઓછા મળશે? ભણવા તો છે જ નહીં, એ તો રિઝલ્ટની ચિંતા કર્યા કરે છે કે જો હું મને સારા નંબર મળશે તો હું અમેરિકા જઈશ, અમેરિકામાં શું કરીશ શું કરીશ, આ બધું વિચારે છે. અચ્છા બીજો છોકરો, હવે એ 12th સાયન્સમાં હતો, 3 વાર ફેલ થયો હતો, આ 4th ટાઈમ હતો. એના પપ્પાની કિરાણાની દુકાન હતી, પણ જો ભાઈ હવે આપણે ભણવું નથી, ઘણું તારા ઉપર મેં ખર્ચો કર્યો, હવે આ બહુ મૂકી દે, આ છેલ્લો ચાન્સ છે, જો આ વખતે ફેલ થયો તો આપણે કરિયાણાની દુકાનમાં બેસી જવાનું છે, હવે આગળ ભણવું નથી. હવે છોકરો ભણવા બેઠો, ભણીને પાના સવેલાવા ગયો, હાય હાય શું થશે રિઝલ્ટ મારું, પાછા થોડા પાને હાય હાય જો હું ફેલ થઈ જઈશ તો, અરર જો ફેલ થઈ જઈશ ને તો પપ્પાએ કીધું કરિયાણાની દુકાનમાં મૂકી દેશે, હાય હાય જો કરિયાણાની દુકાનમાં મૂકી જશે તો પછી મને છોકરી એવી હાવ ગામડિયણ મળશે, મને કોર પણ હશે, છોકરી ગામડિયણ મળશે તો મારું જીવન ઝેર થઈ જશે. પછી થોડાક પણ ગયા, જીવન જેડ જે હતો તો પછી મારે મરી જવું પડશે, તો આત્મહત્યા કરું તો કેવી રીતે કરું, રેલના પાટા નીચે કરું કે ફાંસ ઉગાડી કરું કે ઝેર પીને કરું?
નાના નાના ઝેરપીને કરીશ, અથવા ઝેર ક્યાંથી મળશે, કઈ દુકાનમાં મળશે, આ ક્યાં કરે છે આ બધા વિચાર ભણતી વખતે? પાસ થશે કે ફેલ? તો પરીક્ષાના તૈયારી વખતે ભણવાનું કરવું જોઈએ કે પરીક્ષાના રિઝલ્ટની ચિંતા કરવી જોઈએ? આ જ વાત તો ભગવાન શ્રી કૃષ્ણે કીધી છે 3000 વર્ષ પહેલા. કર્મણ્યેવધિકારસ્તે મા ફલેષુ કદાચન મા કર્મ ફૈલ હેતુર્ભુ મા તે સંગોસ્તુ અકર્મણી. હે અર્જુન, તું કર્મ કર, ફળની ચિંતા છોડી દે. તારું કામ છે કર્મ કરવાનું, મારું ફળ છે ફળ દેવાનું. તું તારું કામ સારી રીતે કરીશ, હું મારું કામ સારી રીતે કરીશ. મારા કામમાં ડબડબ નહીં કર, હું બરાબર તને રિઝલ્ટ આપીશ. પણ તું તારું કામ બરાબર કર, હું મારું કામ બરાબર કરીશ. સ્ટ્રેસ મેનેજમેન્ટ કે ઇતને અચ્છે સિદ્ધાંત, સો મેની નાઇસ પ્રિન્સિપલ્સ ઓફ ટ્રસ્ટ ઓફ ધી સ્ટ્રેસ મેનેજમેન્ટ આર અવેલેબલ ઇન અવર ઇન્ડિયન ઇથોઝ. દેટ ઇઝ વાય ઇન્ડિયન ઇથોઝ આર રિક્વાયર ટુ બી એપ્લાઇડ એટ ધ પ્રેક્ટિકલ ફિલ્ડ ફોર સ્ટ્રેસ મેનેજમેન્ટ. ચા તૈયાર છે? એ ચા તૈયાર છે? નથી તૈયાર. ચા કેટલી વાર છે? ચાને 5 મિનિટ. હજી ચાને 5 મિનિટ છે. 5 મિનિટ બેસો, પછી આપણે છે ને 5 મિનિટ પછી ચા વિરામ કરી તરતો તરત ધડાધડ આવી જશું અને સેટ કન્ક્લુડિંગ સેન્સ થશે. એક્ઝેક્ટ 6 વાગે તમને છોડી દેશો. તમે ચિંતા નહીં કરતા. અત્યારે ગમે એટલું મોડું થાય, તમારા જવામાં જરાય મોડું નહીં થાય. લ્યો, 6 વાગે તમને બધાને બહુ સરસ, ઓલ ઓફ યુ વિલ ગેટ વેરી ગુડ ગિફ્ટ, બ્યુટિફુલ વન્ડરફુલ બુક્સ, એકદમ ઇનવેલ્યુએબલ બુક્સની ગિફ્ટ મળશે, સાથે સાથે સર્ટિફિકેટ પણ મળશે. પણ નામ તમારું પોતાનું લખજો, બીજાનું લખતા નહીં. જે પાર્ટિસિપેટ કરે એને નામ લખવાનું, તમારા ઉપર અમે વિશ્વાસ મૂક્યો છે. અને એમને બ્લેન્ક રાખ્યું છે કારણ કે અમે નામ લખશું વળી એમાં સ્પેલિંગ મિસ્ટેક થશે અને નામે આવા બધા અટપટા હોય છે આજકાલ છોકરા છોકરીઓના મતે, નામે સમજમાં નથી આવે. પહેલાંના બધા નાના નાના નામ હતા, હવે તો કોઈ નામ જોયા એવા એવા બધા નામ આવે, એટલે આમાં જે સ્પેલિંગ મિસ્ટેક તો થવાની જ છે. એટલે મેં કીધું બાપા કાંઈ વાંધો નહીં, એના ઉપર વિશ્વાસ મૂકો, એ પોતાના નામ લખી નાખશે બાપા, હું સિગ્નેચર કરી દઉં. બ્લેન્ક સિગ્નેચર મેં આપેલી છે સર્ટિફિકેટમાં, બ્લેન્ક સિગ્નેચર એ બધી તમને મળશે સર્ટિફિકેટ ઓફ પાર્ટિસિપેશન. તો એટલા માટે ધ થિંગ ઇઝ ધીસ દેટ વાય વી આર ટોકિંગ અબાઉટ ધીસ ઇન્ડિયન ઇથોઝ ફોર મોડર્ન મેનેજમેન્ટ, ઇટ ઇઝ બિકોઝ it is giving us it is very beneficial at the practical field. We had forgotten these values, but gradually we are now rediscovering, reinventing these values, and that has to be applied. So the topics that were given in your brochure, I am trying to finish all the topics. Importance of Indian Ethos of Modern Management, in my inaugural address I had given something. Indian Ethos for Youth Leadership, very nicely dealt with by Sharad Sagar. Lessons from Indian Scriptures for Effective Leadership and Corporate Chanakya for Successful Management. These two topics will be dealt with by Dr. Radhakrishnan, who will be arriving any moment. Practical Vedanta and Trusteeship Management, I have already talked about it, how Swami Vivekananda gave the principle of trusteeship management based on the principle of Vedanta to John D. Rockefeller, which is very important today. Management lessons from Gita, I told you one lesson, Ma Phaleshu Kadachana. Second lesson, we are talking about productivity. Productivity is a must, particularly because now globalization has come, liberalization has come, there is a tough competition, very tough competition, either perform or perish. At that time, we will have to go for productivity. Productivity means not only higher production, but higher production with less resources, with quality remaining constant or quality remaining better. Not at the cost of quality, we have to increase our production. And we have to reduce the cost of expenditure. Unless until we reduce expenditure, we will not be able to have productivity. So productivity is not only higher production, but higher production with better quality
with less consumption of these 5 M's. What are the 5 M's? 4 M's, normally they talk about 4 M's. Management of materials, that is materials management. Management of money, financial management. Management of machines, that is production planning and control. And what is the fourth management? Management of money, financial management, management of man, that is human resource development, HRD. Then management of machines and management of materials. Normally they talk about the four M's, but the fifth M is becoming very important today. What is that fifth M? Management of mind. I told you, if you cannot have stress management, you will not be able to perform better. So management of mind is becoming important, and for management of mind, we have got all the know-how available in our scriptures, in Bhagavad Gita, in the Upanishads. Read the book, Mind and Its Control by Swami Buddhananji, available in the Vivekananda book world. Mind and Its Control. Then Meditation is Method by Swami Vivekananda. Meditation is one of the important factors responsible for giving you concentration of mind. This concentration of mind will again lead you to give you success. So Ralph Waldo Emerson says, the secret of success in trade, in war, in every management of human affairs is the concentration of mind. And that's why Swami Vivekananda said, if I had to do my education over again, I will not undergo the present system of education. First, I will learn how to control my mind, how to concentrate my mind. Information I can have at my own will. He had so much of concentration, yet he wanted more concentration. How much he had? Only two examples I give. Swami Vivekananda was sitting in his room and he was reading a book at Belurmat. You know, I told you about in the morning that Swami Vivekananda started Ramakrishna Mission in 1897. And in 1898, on 9th of December, he started Belurmat, which is the headquarters of Ramakrishna Mutt and Mission. So when you go to Belurmat by the side of the Ganges near Kolkata, you will find very big temple of Sri Ramakrishna, just like this temple in Rajkot. And behind the temple of Sri Ramakrishna, there is a two-storied building. On the first floor, there is a room in which Swamiji himself used to stay. And this room has been kept as it is. His table, his chair, his turban, his clothes, his stick, his musical instrument, everything as it is. You feel as if Swamiji is still staying there. It is in the same room. On 4 July 1902, at the age of 39 years, he left his body in meditation forever. Left his body. And on the wings of meditation, he went to an eternal abode. He left his body. Just before that, a few days before that, Swamiji was in his room. He was reading the book. The name of the book is Encyclopedia Britannica. You must have seen this book. So many big volumes. At that time, his disciple came, Sharachand Chakravarti. When reading the book, he says, oh my God, oh Swamiji, it will take whole lifetime to finish all these reading, all these books. Swamiji says, what do you say? Already I finished 10 volumes and now I'm reading the 11th volume. Huh? Within a few days, you read 10 volumes? I can't believe. You can't believe? Okay. From the first 10 volumes, you ask any questions that you want to ask. And the disciple asked so many questions. And Swamiji replied all the questions and correct replies. Then the disciple was very much astonished. Sharachand Chakravarti said, oh, this is a miracle. Swamiji said, this is not a miracle. What is this? Power of concentration of mind. If your concentration of mind, 10 hour study can be in 1 hour. Many students ask me, how is it possible 10 hour study in 1 hour? I said, it's possible because at present we are doing 1 hour study in 10 hours. Taking the book in the hand, chopdi hatma lidi, aankh kya chhe? Pustak ma, and man kya chhe? પેલું જોઈએ ટીવીમાં પેલો હીરો જતો પેલા વિલનની પીછે પહેલા રસ્તે જતો આ ઓજા રસ્તે જતો તો જલ્દી પકડે અરે તું ક્યાં રસ્તે જાય છે પહેલાં જોતો એ કેટલાય પાના વયા ગયા થાય છે કે નહીં એટ પ્રેઝન્ટ વી આર ડુઈંગ 1 hour સ્ટડી ઇન 10 hours સો વેન યુ ગેટ કોન્સન્ટ્રેશન ઓફ માઇન્ડ 10 hour સ્ટડી ઇન 1 hour એન્ડ સેકન્ડ થિંગ નોટ ઓનલી ઇન સ્ટડી બટ ઇન એવરીથિંગ ઇન એવરી સ્ફિયર ઇન સ્પોર્ટ્સ ગેમ્સ કોમ્પિટિશન મ્યુઝિક એવરીવેર યુ વિલ ગેટ સક્સેસ ઇફ યુ હેવ ગોટ કંટ્રોલ ઓફ માઇન્ડ. If you got concentration of mind. Second time when Swamiji went,
charity. When Swamiji went to America second time, that time he saw, when he was in Camp Taylor, he saw four cowboys trying to shoot at the axes that are floating in water. But their shots were going in vain. There was a string of 12 shots, eggshells. 12 eggshells, not eggs. 12 axes, a string, it was floating in water, and they were trying to shoot the axes, but their shots were going in vain. Swamiji saw for some time, then he started laughing. Now these four cowboys became very much angry. What? You are laughing at us? Is it a small job to shoot at the axes that are floating in water? Okay, we give you the challenge. How do you do it? And Swamiji took up the gun. Swamiji, and this gun was handed over to them. So what to do? Swamiji took up the gun, aimed at the axes, flat. 12 axes gone in 12 shots. And these cowboys became very much astonished. They asked, Swami, how long you are practicing? We are practicing from 5 years. How long you are practicing? Swamiji said, my dear friends, I'm holding the gun for the first time. Huh? First time? And you finished all the 12 axes. That is a miracle. Swamiji says, this is not miracle. That is the power of concentration of mind. How to get concentration of mind? Read the books of Swami Vivekananda. That is in your bag. That you will get kit. Because now tea is ready. So I will not be, then we have to go for the final thing. If I get the time, I have a lot of things to share with you. And I am here only. Again, we will have another program. No problem. But now we must have tea break. Before that, something will be. Now, we have to we have to go for the concluding function very quickly. So within 15 minutes, you must come back. 15 minutes, you must come back after tea, and then we start the concluding session. Also, we